Hey everyone, CEO Bowtie here with another episode of Trauma Team with special guests.
Caleb.
Taylor.
You guys made that seem so awkward.
Well, I had cheese and Taylor's eating a cookie.
Whatever, I'm gonna start. It's my show, I get to decide when we start and when we stop.
It is very true.
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Hang on.
The door stayed on.
What are you doing? You're late.
Oh, hey, Chief. Oh, sorry I'm late.
He still got the belt on.
You're all out of breath, too. Odd. Where were you?
Out in the courtyard?
The courtyard, huh? Oh, what's your take on this, kid?
He's lying.
It's a lie. Courtyard is less than 90 seconds away. Even if he'd run from there, he wouldn't be breathing this hard.
See, he's still wearing his belt.
I'm pretty sure that's his regular belt.
Really,
but...
Dr. Freebird?
We'll see if it changes.
Enough. I know you're all friends, but playtime's over. Let's begin the conference. About 10 minutes ago, a Farris wheel collapsed in Oakdale.
Okay.
We're receiving 4 patients, one of whom is severely injured. The patient's name is Charlie Malone, a 39-year-old male. He has a steel beam in his abdomen and needs surgery stat.
So we have his ID. Has his family been notified?
That still needs to be done.
So that means right now, prisoner CR or whatever.
No.
Is handling one while Hank is going to be handling another one. Maria's probably going to be doing something else.
Huh? What is it to Moe? Why not ask him to perform the procedure? I've seen the video of his operation. He's better than us. Severe organ damage is anticipated and we'll need his skill.
Why is his wind always... Why is his hair always blowing?
I agree. He's amazing.
Well then, it's decided. We'll count on you, kiddo.
How old is he? I don't know.
It's impossible to tell. Like, he has that face where he could be like 17 or 18.
I was gonna say he's 15.
Nurses, prep for surgery.
Please move. Make way.
Blood pressure 60 over 34. GCS is 3-3, blood type O plus.
Good job.
That's a nice smile.
I think that's painful for me.
Let's move. You! Get out of the way!
Please, listen carefully.
Please?
This will require several steps.
She said plea, right? Not please.
The transfusion, so watch the patient's vitals.
I'm pretty sure
Doctor, is something bothering you?
You!
I'm not worried, it's just...
Why do you guys trust us so much?
Vital squad! Doctor!
Quiet!
They can't do anything because of the metal and the wires.
No time. Contact surgery. We'll bring him in as is.
Oh gosh.
Just.
How we handle this crisis will affect the hospital's name. Is it all right to trust this to an outsider like me?
You let your short time here mislead you in understanding us. You aren't regarded as an outsider here anymore, Doctor. You've already saved 2 lives since you arrived here. All of us believe in our hearts that you'll save this man.
Believe. Stab.
Cardiac arrest, 1 minute. Energy won't stop.
God damn it! We're not gonna let him die on us.
Let's go. Patient seems to have arrived.
You can tell with the commotion in the background.
The extraction of the foreign object is a delicate procedure.
Alright.
I, Tomoe Tachibana, will be supporting you in this task.
Alright.
Let's get to it.
We'll save this patient, no matter what.
He just dies automatically.
First thing is to stabilize him.
All right.
Wow.
Very well.
He's not dead. He's miles at 47.
Charge the AED. Beginning
resuscitation. CMB.
On the beam? That is not a good idea.
Well, are you gonna let me?
Not on the beam.
I'm sorry. I tried doing it correctly. I thought I had to hold it.
Oh my gosh. You just tased him. Through a steel beam. That carries current.
Where is me? Yeah, that's what I was. Alright, where is my gun?
Don't have any. You need to work on other areas.
Alright, I'll use the force sensor while we can see it.
Wait a minute, I want to see the...
Just need to pull this strip. Flash
shard. Flash shard in the middle. Please continue with the secret. The blood is in the way. Please drain it quickly.
Oh, I drain it. That's right. Oh, dumb. Let me handle the small stuff so he can save, keep some blood.
You need grace.
It's gonna be a lot of cutting. Oh. Okay, pull that a little bit.
Yeah, but pull out a giant steel bar with their tweezers.
Don't touch him. I'm not touching him. Go forward. I was about to say, that sticks right back into him, I was going to be upset.
Yes.
No. Wait, we just closing it up?
There's still a piece of glass.
Yeah, I see that. I guess I missed that.
And a piece of metal.
The wire is met with a balloon. Be careful of moving it.
It's a good thing you have x-ray vision.
Well, no, I just use ultrasound to get the...
Okay, look for other areas.
Well, no, there's bruising on the inside. Oh, okay. I didn't even finish that, but okay. Ugh. I don't know.
There must be something higher. The EKG is calmed down. Return to the treatment.
Okay. Finals. Hopefully, ET doesn't copy strike me for that awful singing or humming. I swear. Where could you be? See ya. Alright, I was about to say, are we?
Let's close this patient up. Prepare the sutures.
No, forceps to close.
I know, that's what's
an awfully big stitch.
Please place the bandage on the operation.
Just bathe everything in your magic potion.
Especially that's not cool.
Well done.
There was no shadowy ghost that time.
I know, thank goodness. Well, I mean, this was a different accident.
No bads, 3 hits, 20 cools.
Better be an S, yes.
Alright, you were just as skilled as the rumors say.
Hmm.
Wait, you didn't?
That's why I'm here.
Such modesty. I have much to learn myself as well.
Was probably.
It's good she didn't take after her dad. How old is she?
She's dead. She would be 14 now, if she were still alive.
When did she pass away?
She was killed in a bioterrorism attack 8 years ago.
8 years? Don't tell me. Oh, sorry.
It's in the past now.
That incident at Cumberland College.
My wife taught there. She passed away with my girl.
Hey, did they ever find who was responsible?
That doctor.
You're looking at him?
Yeah. I caught him. Personally. Don't you recognize him? He's standing right there.
Are you joking? He did that?
A side effect of the gas. It erased his memory. But he was found guilty in a court of law for it.
That bastard!
Maria.
Hey, Maria!
See, this is why I was confused with her statement before. It's like, okay, I forgive you. It's like you're in custody.
It's like nothing can stop you.
Emma, stop swooning over the new dog.
Hey! You cock it bastard!
Hey!
Is it you?
Stop the toy.
Did you do it?
Woman!
What are you talking about?
Are you responsible for Cumberland College? Tell me!
I've already been put on trial for what happened there.
Damn it!
What are you doing?
So what then? Have you been lying to us all this time?
Please, calm down, Dr. Torres.
We swore an oath to do no harm.
Dr. Torres, calm down.
Maria, stop it. You can't remember, huh? Screw you! Start remembering. Remember what you did!
She probably worked there during the incident.
I'd like to return to my room. Could you escort me there?
Dun-dun. Well, there's more to learn about this guy, so...
And Maria, apparently.
Yeah, true. I mean, all of them in general, but still, he's the most interesting one with this incident. But you'll get to find that out in a few more episodes, maybe, so...
Stick around.
Yeah. Hope you guys enjoy, and we'll see you guys in the next one. See ya.
Bye.
Bye-bye.